Good morning students. In the previous video we have started the new chapter, that was establishment of company rule in India, that is chapter number 9. We studied how Vasco da Gama discovered India, and the thing was that firstly Europeans were trying to establish their trade in our country, but slowly what happened over here that Britishers, they had gained political control also. How these events happened, we have studied it. Now the Carnatic Wars, you know, in this chapter you will have first Carnatic War, second, third, and so many other wars you are going to have. So you will get confused in these wars. What you are supposed to do, you are supposed to make small notes of these wars. Like if you are reading the Carnatic Wars, so when we will take a first Carnatic War, you will write the place where it took place, who were the participants of the war, who won the war, what happened after the war. These are the points. If you will remember these points, the attemptation of your answer will be very easier for you. The Carnatic Wars. The Carnatic Wars were a series of battles fought between the English and the French for the control of the trading ports of India during the years 1746 and 1763. So these are the events of war that were fought between Britishers and French. These wars were driven by opportunism on all sides, though the native princes did not want to surrender their territory to an outsider power. They often cooperated willingly with Europeans to strengthen their own position. So this was the thing, that our local princes, they wanted to make their own position stronger, that's why they willingly helped Europeans. Then the first Carnatic War, that was fought between 1746 and 46 to 48. The Carnatic War was the result of Austrian Succession War that took place in 1740 between Austria and Prussia. So you know, in Europe, Austria and Prussia were fighting, and the first Carnatic War was the result of that fighting only. How? England and France entered opposite sides in the war. Commodore Barnet, the British naval officer, arrived into India with troops, but the French proposed peace with British. So England and France, they also joined the war, and they both were on the opposite sides. Then a British naval officer, Commodore Barnet, he came to India with his troops to fight with French, but French, they were not willing to do a war. They proposed peace with British. The Nawab of Carnatic, Anwar Uddin, also ordered that there should not be any war. So Commodore Barnet returned to England, but Dupleix did not keep his promise and attacked Madras and occupied it. Afterwards what happened, but Dupleix was also an army general, he was not able to keep his promise, he attacked Madras. The British complained to Nawab. Dupleix was a French. He declared war against the French. The battle took place in 1746. In this battle, Anwar Uddin was defeated by the French. So the thing is that when Britishers came to India, when British naval officer Brunet came to India to fight with French, French proposed peace. But when he went off, French General Dupleix, he attacked Madras and he occupied it. And Anwar Uddin was defeated in this. Then the Austrian Succession War came to an end in 1748. The power of France weakened in India also. France was forced to sign a treaty and hand over Madras back to England. So this was first Carnatic War. It was fought between Britishers and French people, and Anwar Uddin also joined Britishers, and Anwar Uddin was defeated in this. But afterwards, firstly they attacked Madras and they won it, but afterwards French power was declined and they had to sign a treaty and they returned Madras to Britishers. This was the first Carnatic War. Now the second Carnatic War, 1749-54. There was a war of succession between Chanda Sahib and Anwar Uddin for the Carnatic Nawabship. Now there was a fight of succession that who will become a Nawab after the death of a Nawab. After the death of Nizamul Mulk, the Deccan Subedar in 1748, a war broke out between Muzaffar Jung and Nasir Jung. So they are fighting for their succession, that who is going to be the Nawab. The French signed a secret treaty with Muzaffar Jung. Muzaffar Jung was the grandson of Nizamul Mulk. So French ne kya kiya? They took his side. And Chanda Sahib to help them with well-trained French forces. So unke saath mil gaye. They promised him that our well-trained forces are going to help you in the war. So they defeated Nasir Jung and Anwar Uddin. The Nawab of Carnatic gained monopoly of trade over South India. So in this war, Anwar Uddin was defeated and Nasir Jung was defeated. And the gain was that the Nawab, the newly made Nawab, gained monopoly of trade over South India. Means, sare South India ke trade pe usi ka raj chal raha tha. Anwar Uddin died in battle and his son Muhammad Ali ran away. On the other hand, the England plotted with Nasir Jung and defeated the French army. Ab dekho, what happened? Anwar Uddin died. His son ran away. His son doesn't have any role in this. But jo Nasir Jung the, Nasir Jung ne kya kiya? ब्रिटिशर्स को अपने साथ मिला लिया और फ्रेंच को हरा दिया. क्लियर? सो व्हाट दे वर डूइंग, दे वर टेकिंग हेल्प ऑफ फ्रेंच एंड ब्रिटिशर्स टू गेन देयर ओन पावर एंड दैट वाज द मोस्ट स्टूपिड थिंग दे हैव डन इन द हिस्ट्री. द थर्ड कर्नाटिक वॉर, द थर्ड कर्नाटिक वॉर बिगेन इन 1756 बिटवीन द फ्रेंच एंड द इंग्लिश. Again French and the English, because they both were fighting to gain a monopoly over the trade. When the French besieged Madras, Robert Clive sent Collier Ford to occupy Northern Sircars. Ford occupied Northern Sircars and brought Salabat Jung under his control. Ab dekho, third Carnatic War mein kya hua? When the French besieged Madras, when French undertook Madras, Robert Clive sent Colonel Ford to occupy Northern Sircar. Northern Sircar was an important place and Northern Sircar did that. Salabat Jung jo wahan ke nizam the unko hara diya. Under his control, Salabat Jung gave Northern Sircar to the British. So they gave to the Northern Sircar to the British. A battle took place in 1760s at Vendibash between the English and the French. The French were defeated. Pondicherry was occupied by the British. When the Seven-Year War ended in Europe in 1763, the Treaty of Paris was signed. अब देखो, यूरोप में जो वॉर हो रही है, that was clearly affecting the political scenario of our country. Our country's places were, you know, taken by Britishers and French. Our rulers were so busy in their own fighting that they were not seeing that, they were not noticing that their own territories are going in the hands of the outsiders. Robert Clive succeeded in making a name. You know that is not an important thing, but the important thing is between who the war was took place and what was the result of the war and where the war took place. So war was between French and Britishers. Eventually, French East India Company was dissolved in 1770. The French ambitions of establishing an empire in India ended and the British supremacy was firmly established. So, because of these wars in 1770, jo French the, unka jo dream tha, that was ended and now Britishers started gaining power in
India. So these are a little bit confusing, but they are confusing only because you are studying them as a whole. What you will do, you will take your notebook, whether fair, whether rough, what you will do, you will write the Carnatic Wars, and then you will write first, second and third, and then again you will put an arrow under the one, and then you will write the two, that among between who this war was fought, what was the result. Then likewise second and third you will do, and if you will make a flowchart like that, it will be very easier for you to understand these wars or battles. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.